So if you are clapping by just seeing my slides, why do I need to talk anything? Okay, so here we are. As most of you might already know, I'm Tolima. I have in the past time very, very much free time, so I spend a lot of my daily work on organizing various Debian presentations at fairs, exhibitions, roadshows, and well, actually I've been everywhere who wanted to have Debian there. So, could I have please the next slide? So, why I am now here is that we have a small problem. Debian gets invited to many, many events, ranging from South Korea to Toronto, to some South American events. Actually, I counted last year how many invitations the Debian project got, and I think it was around 15 invitations, which we needed to to decline, thanks. Just simply because we didn't found a volunteer to take the time and present Debian at a small event. The funny thing is, that's just a pity. There are people who want us to have here. Some even write really beautiful mails. Dear Debian Project, we want you. Please come visit us. We are such nice people and we really want to have you here. And well, all we can say is, sorry, we tried, we didn't find a volunteer, perhaps next year. That's not nice. So, but the funny thing is that it's not really complicated. I mean, you have some how-tos, you need to write some mails, you need to be polite. So that would be the small summary of my talk. And well, you know, when I got involved in the Debian project, the first thing I made was organizing the Debian presentation at the Linux World Expo in Frankfurt. It was the first event I organized. It was back then one of the two major free software events in Germany. And well, it went pretty well. I didn't fail, also I didn't have any experience. It went well, visitors were happy, we got some good feedback. Well, so believe me if I say that organizing a booth is easy. So, but first, please the next slide. Since I know it's early in the morning and that you might not have got your coffee, well, perhaps we start with a small brainstorming. What do you think is needed for a good event? Okay, for the video, the answer was coffee. Interestingly, we will come to that point later. So,
I think t-shirts are very important because all the people come to the Debian booth and want to buy a t-shirt.
Could you please stand up? So, and where's the camera? Here. Look, he's wearing a t-shirt. It's one of those. Oh, that's another one. Okay. He's wearing a Debian t-shirt and I think it's one of the UK style t-shirts he bought. So, that's possibly a major important point. Because on many events, people will simply come to the Debian booth to buy some merchandising stuff. Oh, damn. Anyone has a keychain? Yes. One of our keychains? Oh! Another example is those keychains here, where you can put your key or anything else. And show beautiful how you like Debian just by wearing it. That's a major point. Well, what is it? We're just talking about merchandising. People come to Debian booths because they love Debian and they want to show it. They won't do this at any event. For example, you might get to some business-oriented Linux event where people might be more interested in a nice tie than a cool t-shirt. So you, well, we get to that point later. So what did you say, Andreas? What do you need? Name tags. Name tags. That's another major important point. People who go to a booth don't want to talk to an anonymous representative. They want to talk to a real person. As funny as it sounds, by wearing a name tag and giving them the chance to, you give them the chance to see you as a person, not just some, someone who is majorly involved and might know what he's saying, but just that you show them your name, that they will trust you more. Sounds funny, but some psychologists might be explain it better than I. But that's it. You need a name. Here's an Amazon point, if I think. Yeah. Here I am.
I stand up. Yeah. Probably something more attractive than only volunteers. So not only a few geeks around the booth, but something nice to show to people and catch their eye or something else, a demo or whatever. This is what I think makes a good or bad booth.
Don't worry, I will mention your bubble box. So, yeah.
Maybe even more important, you need a code of conduct for those manning the booth. You're there to help the people who come and look and not to code and hack.
Yeah, I think I have a picture of some, well, we will take a look at some example booths later. So, anything else you need? Good point. Well, if for something completely different, what about giving away DVDs, CDs? Might be sound very strange if people come to the Debian booth to get a Debian DVD. But there were events where that was forgotten. You don't need to have some sponsored pressed DVDs or some special editions with the latest backports or something. It's cool if you can organize such a thing, but having the possibility to burn, okay, first sheets and then, but having the possibility to burn images on demand is often okay. So people will come to you, to your booth, ask for a CD or DVD, and they are often satisfied if you tell them, wait, please give me 5 minutes and come back. I will. I'll need to burn it. Of course, you need to have playing CDs and the images ready.
Official-looking CDs.
That's okay. So the nice thing is that the people won't go away for 5 minutes. So they will stand with you, and you can have a nice chat with them. It's not a kind of fire and forget thing, so, oh, you have CDs? Oh, thanks, bye. You have the more or less unique possibility to draw them deeper into the project. Perhaps tell them how to report bugs, or show them how to use dev tags or something, or point out how good Debian is internationalized. we had visitors at booth who didn't know that the installer is available in their own mother tongue. Okay, she and then you. Hi.
Well, I've often seen that people come to Debian. I'm speaking in this camera, you know. That people come to the Debian booth for technical support. So it's probably better to have a quiet spot on the side where you can take them and fix their stuff, because I've often seen that they come with their laptops or even with fully fledged computers and ask you to fix some minor or major problem. And it's, I think it's good if they don't really block the booth itself, but you can take them to a nice spot on the side and said, well, of course somebody can help you. If you'll have a seat here, we'll take care of it.
Which leads us more or less to his point, the code of conduct. We had events where we had such a small silent area which we couldn't use for fixing visitors' computers because they were sitting DDs hacking. I know it's quite unusual to sit somewhere and hack. but it happens. So if you... I have my personal assistant to hack for me. or something, you know. If you have such an area, it's okay. But you need a strict code of conduct to not sit there and hack.
I've got a question to the code of conduct. We are all volunteers, so I think it would be really hard to tell the people, if you like to help us at the booth, there's a code of conduct that you have to follow. I think a lot of people say, yeah, then I do not help you, and then you do not have enough people to do the booth.
Well, we have a code of conduct to maintain your packages properly. You need to fix your bugs and also, and it's pretty much the same with volunteers. You have a volunteer who wants to do some job, and well, we have a small minimum criteria which they should fulfill. I don't know of any volunteer who has been thrown away because we told him to behave a little bit. So, okay, now finally you.
On the CDs, we found that charging a minimal fee for them will make it so we can have at least run out during the middle of the second day instead of the first hour. It's,
what's the translation of? Anyone knows the translation of the German idiom Beutelratten? Pack rats, genau. It's usually a good idea. And what might be problematic is that if you got your CDs or DVDs sponsored by some people and then again charge money if you give them away. What we usually do in Germany to solve that problem is that we give the CDs away for a donation of at least 0 cent. So it's some kind of, you give me money, it's as much as you want, and I give you a CD. This draws away those pack rats, thanks, which will just come, take a CD and throw it away later. But it's still okay for most of the others. Of course, if there's a smallish kid, 12-year-old,
you're a Debian developer. Could I please have a DVD? Could you sign it for me?
Which happens. I don't think it's necessary to charge them any money for the DVD. Okay, I think we mentioned pretty much every point. And
flyers and posters for showing some information.
Yeah, if people see that it's a Debian booth, it's a good idea. So the point Mr. Fay mentioned was that it is good to have some posters and flyers. Flyers are especially important because your visitors will then remember that you've been there, that they have been there, most probably even what you were talking about, which is another major point. Another point which I would like to mention is that you should try to have at least one Debian developer nearby. I know it's a bit ridiculous to say that at the Debian conference, but hands up, who is not a Debian developer in this room? Okay. So, but as you know, if you want to join the Debian project, you need your GPG key signed by at least one developer. So, there are people who are interested in joining the project coming to your booth and asking your key to be signed. Their key to be signed. Sorry, I'm a bit confused. It's okay to tell them, sorry, I'm not a DD yet, but I can sign anyway. If you want your key to be signed, wait for an hour, then we'll be Mr. Fay here, who is a DD, who can sign you. It's even okay if you answer something like, I'm sorry, we have not a DD here yet, but he will be here tomorrow at 12 or something like that. Just give them the opportunity to have their key signed. They are really, really, not to say pissed off, but disappointed, if they travel to an event, meet some Debian folks, but well, it's for them nothing more than a nice chat. So, anything else left? Okay. Please? Okay. The answer was have a piece of paper and a pen so you can write down what you tell your visitors. I'm impressed. I would have think that if I do a talk set such early in the morning, I need to do anything myself. But okay. So could I have the next slide? The next slide. Ah. Okay. A small example of a booth. Okay, who can tell me what these guys are doing wrong?
They're facing away from the crowds.
Okay, so that is one point that is not the point I would like to have mentioned. Perhaps you come a bit nearer to the picture and you will recognize it yourself and won't be beaten by all the women in the crowd.
I think the background of their desktop does not fit to the booth.
Yes. Okay. What's hard to see if you are sitting back? This is a, more or less naked woman. it might work at a booth at a some kind of porn or woman-related event, I don't think it's a proper thing to do at a free software conference. But that's a good example. I didn't notice. The people are facing away from the visitors. I didn't notice. Yeah. Please? It's not Debian. I don't know what it is. It's not a Debian booth.
Sorry? If it had been a Debian booth, I guess I would have had a big Debian logo, which is missing.
So, yes.
I see another, I think, major fault on it. On the right side, they have a lot of space for a poster, but only put a A4 small printout on it. So they do not use the space they have. And if you're standing maybe 2 meters from this sign, you cannot read it.
That's not even their own. That's the sign. So the organizer of the event put there, so they will find their booth. So they didn't even print something themselves. So, I hate it if I see such thing because I consider it just a waste of the resources of the organizers who are offering the booth for free. And the least thing you can do is to try to organize a proper booth.
What is another error that can't really be seen on the picture very well is that what the people were doing is not actually like demoing their system emulation software, but they were playing a game on the left laptop, where you had to answer quiz questions, and for every right question, a nice lady would undress herself a bit more. So they were they generally were distracted by non-booth activities.
So, and I think we can agree that people who should staff a Debian booth should agree in a code of conduct to not do such things. Please give me this next example. Okay, another point?
Not really another point, but what I wanted to say before in the brainstorming section, it would be nice if we had some, Debian Boost package, something like that, or Debian Boost Live CD, which brings a default Boost layout to the computers we have.
It's on my to-do list for about 2 years. I think it will be done within the next 10. Here we have that is a Debian booth from last Linux Tag. Actually, it isn't the picture I was looking for, but it was the best picture of that booth I could find. It's not your fault, it's my fault. Now, imagine what we have already said. We have some Debian stuff. You can see more or less that this is a Debian booth. And we have here an empty area where you can talk with people about their problems. What do you think happens?
The first impression is that it is quite, it is really not crowded by people, so it's not really attractive for people.
The picture was taken really early in the morning, even earlier than we have now.
So we should serve some coffee?
Yes. What happened later that day that people showed up, that some Debian folks woke up and say, immediately crowded this part of the booth, put up their notebooks, started taking chatting, all the stuff you usually don't do at an event. What you can see is that they tried to put some stuff on to show, here is Debian. I don't think it is working very well, but actually I don't know how I would have done it any better, because the booth itself didn't have much opportunity to show your own thing. What would probably be nice is if you have here a really big red swirl for people to see it. Another thing you could see is, you see this kind of, it's a two-sided kind of booth. And what you apparently don't see is that this booth is more or less empty. So at this Debian booth, there was exactly one computer to show Debian stuff. And, well, this machine was either buzzy, or people didn't know the password or whatever to use it to show some stuff. Now, imagine the situation. You are a volunteer for a Debian booth. You get there, you see a visitor who's waiting and apparently has a question, and yeah, there's this computer you could use to answer his questions or to at least help him by showing him the right mailing list to ask or the right IRC channel. And you can't do it because you don't know the fucking password. So another point which we should have added previously in the brainstorming is that you communicate to your volunteers, that you make sure that they know how to use the computers, what questions could arise, and all that stuff. I mean, what's generally a good idea is to prepare some kind of FAQs you can expect at the event, depending on the kind of event you're going to. Stuff like, when will Edge be released? Or, well, how does support for the Debian distribution work? And of course, the people at the booth should be able to answer the most common questions. I think that's pretty much about that example.
What about having some kind of advocacy when brainstorming or stuff like that? Some advocacy of what's really cool with Debian with this kind of computer or this.
I think that's part of communicating with your volunteers. And of course, it's a major part of the role of organizing such event to inform yourself of the nature of the event. For example, if you go to CeBIT, people might be interested in seeing how Debian runs on the AMD64 port. They might not be that interested in seeing how Debian runs on the HPPA port, to give one example. So there was one other. Oh, you!
I think a common problem that I often see on Debian booths is that the people who are advertising Debian there have been using it for years. And when they are asked what's so great about Debian, like a visitor comes by and says, so, okay, what's about this OS? They will say the things that they like most about it at the moment, like, yeah, you know, we now have 64-bit support, and we have this and that, and you can compile some things in this and that way. Because, yes, Debian also is highly stable, it's running on thousands and millions of languages, but it's always been like that, so we don't realize that anymore as such a special feature. So, but to somebody who's totally unbeknown to Debian, this is actually what's much more important than, say, the umpteenth port on whatever other architecture. But people aren't aware of it because we've been with Debian for years and it's been doing that for years. So for us, it's normal. So maybe it would be good to have a list of things to mention or to show, maybe a poster that people can just read or something.
Or if you have some kind of beamer, projector, what about a nice set of slides running there in a loop mode, showing the most important information for your visitors? Having a poster is nice, but you can't react to visitors with a poster. If you see that most of your visitors ask a question which isn't answered on your poster, you can put post-it notes on it or something like that. I think it's a better idea to just change your slides. Okay, last example, please. Okay. That was the booth at no, it was in this millennium. I think it was a small booth wie heißt nochmal das kleine Land zwischen Deutschland, Frankreich und Luxemburg. Sorry. Okay, this is a Debian booth at an event in Luxembourg. The nice thing is that we could find many, many things to improve here, but forget it. There were no visitors at that event, and so it would have been wasted time to do a proper booth, more or less. It's just another example of, we have here, you could guess it's a bag of those keychains. So we have the attempt to have some merchandising here. It could have been, better placed. Please? There's fancy hardware, which didn't work very well at that event. Originally, we had some posters right here, which you can't see even if the picture was right there, because the organizer of that event asked us to turn them down from the walls. What you can see here is someone with the back to the visitors. Not very nice, if there had been visitors. What you can't see on this picture is that this is an example of an event where no Debian developer was present. So we couldn't do much things. Christoph Berg wasn't DD at that time. It's an older picture, I think from 2004. One second. During the event, we had the idea to use it to do some bug squashing and all that kind of stuff. But it was a bit complicated because we had no DD there to sign our packages.
Yeah. When I was just had only been using Debian for a few months, I wound up, I volunteered to help with the booth and wound up running the booth for, and without any help. Try and get at least two people for the whole day. Maybe if it's a lightly attended event like that, you don't need two people the whole day, but the events I've gone to, two is absolute minimum. Make sure and get your booth set up before the event opens. we would really like to have a nice banner, but it's a money problem.
In general, it shouldn't be a money problem. If you write a nice mail to our BLOV DPL asking them for some money to print some posters, some flyers, small banner, and that kind of stuff. We didn't have any problems with that in the past. One final thing I would like to mention. Another point you can't see on this picture is the event took place in a suburb of Luxembourg, pretty much away from anything. So we were sitting there the whole day waiting for a visitor, and nothing to eat, nothing to drink, and well, we had internet. We could have tried to find some pizzeria to order some food, something like that. But it sucked. Says it. So if you organize a booth and have your volunteers here, the least thing you can do is to take care of them. And I've still some time left. I think so. At least no one is throwing me out, so I will continue. Take care of your volunteers. One point. You might need them next year when the event takes place again. Point number two. You can't expect your volunteers to be nice to your visitors if they are hungry, thirsty, and don't have been on the toilet for the last 6 hours. So try to organize something to drink, some sandwiches, bread rolls, anything, just so they have the possibility to take something to eat, hide behind some kind of wall so they won't be seen, and eat their stuff. In general, it's not looking very nice if there are people staffing the booth, or they're filled with food, or if the visitors come and ask these questions, they're like, you should try to avoid that. So, you have?
Yeah, about the volunteers, I think one of the most important points, especially in crowded events, is to identify the volunteers, so that visitors know who is a volunteer and who is not. So asking them politely to at least wear a Debian T-shirt would be a good idea, so that they are immediately identified as the Debian people and the volunteers of the booth. We had such experience in the Solution Linux in France, which is very, very crowded with many volunteers, but no one knows who is the volunteer.
Yeah, if you can, try to set some kind of standard. So, for example, in 1 year, we had a big sponsor for the Linux Tag. So we used part of that money to create a common set of polo shirts with all the same logo and all looking the same. Because the problem you might have is that all your volunteers are wearing some kind of Debian shirt, but all your visitors are wearing them too. So you have a point to add? Okay.
Yes. Always make sure when you accept an invitation to man a booth that there will be somebody there. I was invited once. We got an invitation once to a business-oriented exhibition. So I said, yes, of course. Well, it was in another city, so I didn't really know who was there, but they said, well, I can go. But it was in the same time as DevConf. So I didn't have anybody to send there. Well, I thought they would be willing, but in the end, well, having an empty booth is not nice for the organizers, so we never got invited again.
And it's disappointing for your visitors too, because it happens that people just go to an event because they read that Debian will be there. It happens, especially if they want some key signing or something like that. So, 10 minutes. Oh, sorry for good timing. So, to summarize up, next slide, please. Inform yourself about the event. What is it kind of? Will it be visited by business people, or will it be visited by geeks? If it's visited by geeks, you might want to wear your cool shirt. If it's visited by business people, you might want to at least wear trousers without holes in it. Sometimes you even want to wear a real shirt, not a t-shirt, and maybe even a sacco, and take care of your hair. Okay. So, next point. What questions will they ask? Will they be more interested in getting their own software into Debian? Or will there be mainly users who might have some kind of technical problem with their preferred desktop environment or something like that? It's no problem. It's okay if you don't know the answer. What you should be able to is to point them somewhere where they can find the answer. So if they are KDE users or something like that, you might want them to the to the user list in their language. If they have a problem packaging their software, you want to point them to the mentors list. Even if you don't know how to start that KDE software or fix that deep patch problem they have.
Just a question. I haven't read the booth how-tos, but is there some kind of frequently asked questions of visitors? So, for instance, what is the best distribution and what is the answer to this question?
Yes. I'll show you the URLs later on the second last slide, I think. So, what can you do to answer their questions? So, next slide, please. And as said, take care about your volunteers. Okay, take care about your volunteers. They must be happy to make your visitors happy. Get the next one. If you are at a larger event, might be happen that sooner or later your volunteers or even yourself burn out. If you get asked the same stupid question 20 or 30 times a day and you need to answer it more or less the same way, it's boring and just burning out. So, if you notice that you or any other volunteer at the Debian booth shows signs of being not as nice as they usually are, or is giving answers to visitors with a slight tone of being annoyed, you might want to try to tell them politely to take a small break. It happens. It happens even to, well, professionals like me. I hope you saw that I had quotation marks about the professionals I said. And before you fuck up with visitors, take a break. Go 10 minutes walking around, preferably somewhere far, far away from the place where the event takes place. Take a walk, look a little bit in the sunshine. Most probably don't even take your notebook and read even private or project or something like that. That's a pretty stupid idea if you want to clear up your mind. So, you might need a break. So, last slide, please. So, we have already written down some how-tos at the major Debian website, even translated in many, many languages, and something in the wiki, which is more up to date. And here are the frequently asked questions. I think they might need an update in the meantime because we released Edge. So that's more or less my talk. Of course, we are free to discuss until we are thrown out here.
Yes, it would be nice if there was a current flyer that we could just print out. I noticed for our event, there was a flyer that was a little bit out of date and formatted for A3 or A4 or whatever the European standard format, and so didn't fit on letter-sized paper, and we had to munch it around, and it was still quite out of date. And
actually, there's this flyer which is made with LaTeX and translated into many languages, which is used by, I think, many events. So the source code of that flyer is somewhere mentioned on the first URL. And, well, I think it is maintained on Alias. So feel free to help us maintaining it and make it fit on your paper.
But I think we have the A4 version of this flyer with one side German, one side English, and we have printed several thousand things, and maybe we should just spend some money the Debian project has to send, for example, 300 of the flyers to other people that are stuffing a booth in an English-speaking country. So it's I think, much nicer because they're really good printed, and nobody has to get this LaTeX file, adjust it, find somebody who prints 20 or 50 things. We already have them in a huge amount or can produce them, and then we just have to ship them to other events.
Okay. Feel free to ask for help, for resources, for merchandising stuff. We have a lot of stuff, flyers, t-shirts, keychains. I think we have still several thousand keychains available. Not here. Okay. What I forgot to add to my slides is that there are several mailing lists which you can use to coordinate your event, to ask for help. And the least thing you should do is to write a mail to events@debian.org. They can help you. They can try to advertise your event. They can add your event to our homepage so people will know that you are there and all that kind of stuff. And, well, that they can create contact. If you need flyers and he has some, we most likely know it. So.
I'd like to give us another recommendation, maybe more work to do, but after the event, it could be a good idea to write down a small report and post it to the Debian events -NA or -EU mailing list. It's probably interesting for others to know how it went and what happened at the event.
Yep. Might be even more interesting if so the main organizer from the Debian side of the event changes over the years. So he can take a look at old reports to get a feeling about the event, what has gone wrong, what could have been done better, all that kind of stuff.
It does also help a lot to have a place where you can put some stuff which is easily accessible and which cannot be seen like from everywhere around, because people will bring bags and a lot of stuff and it just does not look nice if that's lying around somewhere on the booth. And yes, we had that picture of Linux Tag and there was actually a lot of place, but it could just be accessed through the top. So when there was something standing on it, you could not get there and, well, it just sucked.
Here.
Yes. Correctly. But there was no other place to put stuff. So, well, the thingies that were standing around there were provided by the organizers. And so you might talk to them before the event and check what kinds of stuff will be available, and yes, that might help.
I think that's already part in the how-to reword, that you take care about that.
I'd like to advertise a bit further the how-tos on the Debian Wiki, because what they mainly hold is an extensive list of extensive checklists that are really handy. There's checklists there, for example, what you need for a booth. They hold all the things that you always need and never bring, like adhesive tape or for you, because everybody brings a poster but nobody brings tape. That's what usually happens. And so there's a list what to bring for the booth. There's lists when you try to or when you want to write reports on the event, like what information should be included in the report. Those lists are also separated, like what kind of information should go into an official report and what kind of information should go into an intern report to other developers. And then there's also a draft code of conduct that is loose enough so people don't feel annoyed by it, but it still well guarantees for a minimum amount of decency. So there's lots and lots of lists there that you can just print out and tick off. So they're really handy. And I just keep on talking until somebody takes this mic off me.
No, I have my own. Okay, so time's up. If you like, just try to catch me while I'm here. We can talk further if you have any points left, which I didn't mention yet. Or just write an email either to me or, as I said, to events@debian.org. So many thanks for showing up. I'm really impressed to see that many people here, even early in the morning. I'm especially impressed to see you more or less awake. Many thanks.